The Realme devices continue to receive security patch updates along with some minor camera tweakings and bug fixes. But the November update, which had a size of around 335 MB, added some few yet significant features and bug fixes. As an owner of the new Realme 5, this video is all about the features, new features added to this specific phone, along with the removal and modification of the features that were previously a bit irritating. So, without further ado, let's get started. So, before we get started with this video, make sure to click that subscribe button and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my latest uploads. So, everybody expected that these new features will be added to Realme's own Realme OS. Instead, Realme went on to modify the Color OS exclusively for Realme devices and add these new features to the Color OS itself. So, let's get started with the new features. The first one was the most anticipated and the most requested one. It was the dark mode. Now, Realme devices did take a little bit of time in adding the dark mode, but it's finally here. Now, you can enable the dark mode in your phone if you own a Realme 5 by going to the settings, scrolling down and going to the Realme Lab portion, then clicking on that and you will find the dark mode switch, which you can click to enable the dark mode. Now, after enabling dark mode, you will find that you can manually enable and disable the dark mode in some of the applications that you have in your smartphone, because there will be some applications which will be able to adapt to the dark mode, while there will be some applications which will be having problems with the dark mode itself. Like, I experienced issues by enabling dark mode in the Gmail, because while typing or composing a new mail, the letters and the fonts that I was typing was not visible. There was also a bit of problem with the WhatsApp, where the color of the chats I send became a little bit of green on the darker side. The second feature that comes out significantly is the wide angle video shooting. Now, previously we only used to shoot videos using the primary lens of the camera, but now you can shoot videos using the 8 megapixel wide angle lens present in the smartphone itself. Now, you can find this mode in the stock camera app itself by switching on to the video mode, and there you will find the icon to switch to the wide angle lens and you can shoot the videos. The third feature that I'm going to talk about is not that significant, but it is worth mentioning. Now, it is about swiping the notifications to remove them. Now, earlier there was this issue that whenever you are using your smartphone and you received a notification like a WhatsApp message or an Instagram DM, what happened is that if you swiped left or right, you are not able to remove them. Now, in the latest update, you can swipe it left or right and you can remove that message prompt or the notification you receive. The fourth and the last update is regarding the notification bar. Now, previously, if you are familiar with sharing mobile data with your friends or using it with a laptop using the mobile hotspot, then you may have noticed that there was a blue indicator which popped up in a few seconds, which showed how much data was being used through the portable hotspot or the mobile hotspot. Now, I felt that this wasn't necessary and was a bit irritating, and this issue has been fixed with the latest November update, where this has been removed. Now, this is good because it actually wasn't needed and it's better that it has been removed. Now, the next feature was also related to the notification bar itself. It was the addition of the fast toggle between the SIMs. Earlier what happened is that I had a mobile data package activated in both of my SIM cards. Now, I had to go through the process of going to the settings and then going to the SIM settings and then changing the SIM with which I want to use my mobile data. Now, I can easily go to the mobile notifications and toggle the SIM 1 or SIM 2 with which I want to use my mobile data. So those were all the features in the November update that I found were significant. Now, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click that like button, and in case you found any other features that were significant and I missed, then make sure to comment down below. And there was one feature that I also wanted Realme to include in this update was the screen timeout button in the notifications, because that is actually necessary, because when I will be reading some ebooks or any PDF in my phone, what happens is that I have to manually go to the settings and change the screen timeout time. Now, if it was actually present in the notifications, if the button was present in the notifications, it would have been a lot better. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.